Here is a little added note to Karen's back scrubber, or pet leash, as I made another one here, headband. Also, I forgot to mention a purse handle, but I did add that in the description. But what I tried was, well, not this cotton, but the kitchen cotton I had, I put my tension dial down to 4, and it worked with no problem, like it did with the acrylic. I have mentioned that to a few people, but when you do not machine knit every day, you tend to forget a few things here and there. So later on, I tried it and it worked. I had already got the video up, so I was like, I'll just have to add a new one, which I'm doing here. But anyways, I misunderstood Karen's pattern on how she got hers blue and white together. And I thought it was knit 10 rows of one color, knit 10 rows of another color, and I think you could see that black riding up here, and then I got the white going there. What I did was, instead of cutting the yarn, I just let it ride up the side, and when I started the new yarn, I would have to pull down the yarn on the yarn mask back here so that it didn't pull up that first stitch too tight. The one of the little ends here, I only did 20 rows, I think it was, of the I-cord, or maybe it was 30 rows. The handle, I know I did do 56 rows. It's a little tight, but I could still get my hand in there, but this may not work for a man, so you would do a little bit more rows, or even make it long like I showed in this purple one here, and sew it together, or they could just hold it like that. But what Karen really did, and this is why I had to take this one apart to show you. Now, she had blue and white, but I've got blue and orange. So I'm going to take the blue, push it through the orange, and then I'm going to leave it right here. Even though there's a hole there, I probably shouldn't have had the hole. Oh, and I did it the wrong way, I guess. It doesn't really matter because it's going to curl on itself. Then I took the orange. Now I'm skipping the next hole here. That may be the one I have to go into, but I found that if I skipped that hole and went up to the next one, but I take the other color, in my case orange, and I pull it through. Yeah, I'm doing it wrong because the knit sides are facing each other. Okay, so, start again. I'm going to take the blue, I'm going to put it through the orange with the knit side facing up. Going that one hole up, and I'm going to twist that so that they're on each other. So the blue went through the orange, now I have to put the orange through the blue. And I believe I did, because I was on the HK100, I did 12 rows with this. So it does look a little long, but as you see, doing two more rows, you don't have to follow a pattern to a T. You could change it whichever way you want. So, blue went through orange, orange through blue. And I'm going to do that right up to the end. So now, here, on this end here, I'm just going to be grabbing the few stitches on the fold here to make that I cord. When I get to the other end, I'm just going to have to fiddle with it to get it just right so that I only have the 3 or 4 stitches. But doing it double like that, it may be a little bit more. You may want to hand knit the first row or two. But as you see, now it's starting to look more like in Karen's blog.